As can be seen in the chart and table, Turkey had a relatively stable level of net lending, ranging from 0.2% of GDP to 0.6% of GDP during the period between 2013 and 2015. The increase in expenditure in 2016 led to a shift from net lending to net borrowing, and the slight decline in revenue in 2017 contributed to an increase in net borrowing. To finance this borrowing, more liabilities were incurred, and the net acquisition of financial assets was lower than in previous years. An analyst would want to dig into those details to see the structure of those assets and liabilities. In contrast, between 2013 and 2015, the United Arab Emirates experienced larger swings in net lending net borrowing, with 2.7% of GDP in net lending in 2013, shifting to net borrowing of almost 7% of GDP in 2015, a change of about 9.5 percentage points of GDP. Net borrowing lessened over the next 2 years and was just 0.2% of GDP in 2017. Let us look at the components behind the deterioration of net lending net borrowing between 2013 and 2015. Revenue fell significantly during those 3 years, almost 7.5 percentage points of GDP, while at the same time expense rose by over 1.5 percentage points of GDP. As a result, the gross operating balance declined by 9 percentage points of GDP during that period. An analyst would want to investigate the factors behind these events. Gross investment in non-financial assets remained relatively stable, adding about 0.5 percentage point of GDP during the period. To meet its financing needs of almost 7% of GDP in 2015, the UAE reduced its financial asset stocks by 3.5% of GDP and incurred almost another 3.5% of GDP in liabilities. Once again, an analyst would seek information on the composition of these net disposals and incurrences to better understand the impacts of such financing.